Welcome back, everyone, to the second part of our sensational adventure in the Philippines. If you want to know the way we feel about Boracay, well, all I can say is the following. Stand back, Vegas, Amsterdam, London, LA and Barcelona. Boracay is the ultimate tropical, bustling, hardcore and mouthwatering destination to visit.
And by the way, if you still haven't seen the first part of our adventure in this amazing country, I would like to leave you the link over here so you can click on it and you can also see what we did in Manila. As for now, stay tuned until the end of this video. On the first stage, upon arrival, we were delighted by a display of local music. And it was really interesting because, in all honesty, it felt as if we had got to Bali. As soon as we collected our luggage, we got our transfer with this company called Southwest. We paid 1,050 pesos each. They take you from the airport to Cataclan Port. And then they take you on a boat to Boracay. And finally, they will take you to a hotel. However, we were told that if you get your transport by yourself, you can pay way less than with this company. You also must know that you cannot enter the island unless you have a hotel reservation, due to the fact that the place is really famous and quite small. The island is so idyllic that even the beach by the port is amazing. And for the end of the day, since it was my birthday, we decided to go for a lovely and delicious meal.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Boracay. In today's video, I'm going to be giving the introduction since poor Victor last night got ill. He was coughing, he couldn't speak, he had a temperature, and he was feeling absolutely awful. So unfortunately today, he's going to take a break and I'm going to be doing the talking. As you can see, this is the lovely hotel where we are. We have an amazing view of the palm trees, the white beach, people are swimming. There are so many tropical vibes that you cannot imagine. You have to come with us now to see White Beach and the promenade. Let's go.
We are extremely lucky since we've got the beach right in front of our hotel. Do you know that the beautiful island of Boracay was named as one of the world's greatest places in 2022? According to the prestigious yearly list of international magazine Time.
So right here we are located between White Beach and Station 3. It's the best place to be since you've got long strips of sand, you've got all the shops and bars here, and this part of White Beach, for me, is the best part.
But before going for a dip in the sea, Richie had to buy a big hat because we don't want to have another episode of sunburns like in Rio de Janeiro. That was extremely painful. Now that we all are safe and sound from the sun, we can definitely go for a nice, lovely swim at this lovely beach. But then we thought that it is kind of impossible to get burned at 9 AM in the morning, so we decided to take the hat off and we went for a nice, lovely swim eventually. So everyone, I can finally say something. I kind of got my voice. I still sound like a little bit like husky, but well, it's just a lot better than nothing. So right now we are going out for lunch. Let's see what we can get. I really would like to have something as tasty as yesterday. And it's kind of hard for me to talk because obviously I've got a lot of phlegm and yeah. So let's see what Boracay has. To be walking by the sea with these lovely temperatures is like real luxury. The winter got really cold back in Europe, and therefore to be here for us is like being in paradise. We came to the same place where we had dinner yesterday, at the sea market, we ordered a whole kilogram of tuna, a milkshake, a mango milkshake to be specific, and then we got a big ration of scallops. Everything was absolutely delicious. Even though today is our first day here in Boracay, I feel stress-free. Walking around this island makes me feel so happy that I feel like having a nice cup of coffee and enjoy the lovely vistas surrounding me. Now back to the beach. Right now we would like to show you one of the must visit places when you are here in Boracay. I'm talking about the mall. This is the place or one of the main places where you can get your souvenirs before you go back home. You can find so many shops, so many restaurants, and you can just literally have a lovely time walking around seeing what you can buy to bring with you back home. You can go more than once, the place is rather big, and to be honest, the prices are really good, so it's nothing like if you went to the Middle East or the Caribbean, where they try to con you all the time. Later that day, this is what we had for dinner.
Good morning everyone, so today is our second day here in Boracay. And yesterday we bought a tour to do something extremely interesting that I always wanted to do, that I wanted to do actually in Cancun, Mexico and in Rio, Brazil, but I couldn't because we didn't have enough time. But here we managed to find a nice tour, and we are going to go parasailing. So this is basically when you are pulled by a catamaran and then you basically are lifted in the air with a parachute, something like that. So this is going to be quite interesting. Right now we're going to be taken into the sea, and later we're going to get that lovely experience, and I really cannot wait to have it.
To be honest with you, I've got butterflies. I'm not gonna deny the fact that I'm extremely nervous about this, especially as, you know, like in Namibia, we had to waive the responsibility from injury and death, and we had to do the same here. However, lots of people are doing it, and it promises to be a fun activity.
Ready or not, here we come. I would like to give you a piece of advice. If you want to experience a few things in this life, just go for them. Don't let your fears stop you from doing them. Why? Because I remember that when we were in Brazil with Richley, we really wanted to go paragliding and we didn't. Our friends did, but we didn't because we were kind of scared. But today, this is not going to happen. I'm feeling a tiny bit scared, but I don't really care because I really want to live this lovely experience. In hindsight, it is not that scary because they gradually let you go in the air. And to be honest, even if we fail, we are over the sea. That means that we can still swim. So there is nothing to be worried about. The only bad thing I didn't like about this activity is the fact that they take the telephone from you and you cannot take any pictures or make any videos. I gave my telephone to this woman and I thought that she could make a lovely video. Then this man came and took my telephone from her. And let me tell you just one thing, if he had to work as a cameraman, he would be fired. In any case, we still had a great experience, and guess what? The sun is out. It means that everything seems more positive.
So guys, we just had a problem, you know, we had an argument at the place where we had lunch. So basically, when we ordered the fish and the oysters, we had to wait for 15 minutes. And then when the fish came to our table, when they brought the fish to our table, the fish was completely incinerated. It was
completely burned.
It was literally ash, you know, just pure ash. And so it was not nice at all. And later, the oysters were boiled. It's like...
Who boils oysters?
Well, some people might, but we don't do that. It's like, hello, it's like in Europe, we just basically have them with lemon. And in Namibia, we had them with lemon. Why would we boil the oysters? Obviously, it was a fiasco. And then when we had fixed the price at front, then later they came with a 10% charge, you know, service charge,
which we accepted.
And then they wanted us to pay 400 pesos for the kitchen fee, and I was like, really? It's like, so I was willing to pay, Richie was not, so we had a bit of a row there.
It was a bit of a heated argument,
and I was like, oh, do you know what, I would like to advise you something. When you go to these places, just pay a little bit more and go to a decent, normal restaurant. Because if you go to those ones, it may be cheaper, but they might end up actually calling you. So if you want to be like relaxed and you don't want to be worrying about being scammed, I would actually recommend you going to a normal restaurant, pay a tiny bit more, but you know what? You can relax and you don't have to be worrying.
I'm very disappointed because I know that there's a lot of fresh seafood here in Boracay, but you've got to be very careful where you go. We've already had seafood in other places and we weren't charged with this secret cooking charge, but here they gave for this secret cooking charge and we said no.
And to compensate the fact that we didn't eat enough because everything was literally burnt, we went to this restaurant to have another meal, a real one, and it was really nice and tasty. And afterwards, it got kind of hot and stuffy, therefore we went back to the mall to have a lovely mango shake, and believe me, it was to die for. If there is something I like about Boracay, it's the fact that there is not a sense of danger whatsoever. You can walk at any time and everything is going to be alright. And also, we haven't been hawked or targeted just because we are foreigners. And to make this trip even more tropical, we are going to have some coconut water. And for the end of our second night here in Boracay, we are going to have a blue margarita enjoying this amazing live music.
Good morning everyone, so today is our third day here in Boracay and we decided to go on another tour. This time we are going to go around the island. I still don't know the places that we're going to be visiting, but of course I'm going to be sharing all of them with you so you can have an idea about the beauty of this lovely place on earth, which is Boracay.
There is another thing I like about Boracay, and it is the fact that you don't have to go to any tour office. There are many people selling tours along the beach, and they do it in a very kind and gentle way. They don't hawk you, and I really appreciate that. As soon as we got on the jetty, I almost killed myself, but thanks to God, it didn't happen. By the way, at this point, we still didn't know where we were going because the man didn't have the amiability to speak in English. He spoke in pure Tagalog. In any case, we still got to enjoy the views.
So everyone, we just got to the first spot of the tour, which is Balinghay Beach. And so basically, we couldn't get like as near to the shores of the beach, and we had to get in the water. And what an experience. Do you like it?
It's an amazing island, but there are lots of people. Excuse my voice, I'm a little bit aphonic today. Now it's my turn.
The beauty of this place is almost indescribable. No wonder why it was voted as one of the most beautiful places on earth.
Okay guys, so we woke up this morning very early at 8, our tour started at 9, and basically we're going with a big group of people around the islands, and hopefully there'll be a chance to see some tropical fish because we're going to go snorkeling. However, there was a hidden cost. They said you've got to pay an extra 40 pesos for the snorkel, and that wasn't told about. So my advice is when you come on these excursions, you have to say, are there any other hidden extra costs?
In any case, as Richard said, later we were taken to a specific place in the sea to go under the water. Although, to be honest with you, we couldn't see that much because the thing that we got to put the telephone inside got a little bit blurry, and therefore we don't have a quality footage of it.
We were taken to another part of Boracay, not exactly where all the resorts are, but it's in an area where there are lots of local people on this island of Boracay. We were given a fantastic lunch buffet, shrimps, beef, rice, vegetables, absolutely delicious. And with this setting here, you really can't go wrong.
I really enjoyed the fact that they took us to a place that was not touristic at all and we got to see local people. Shortly after, we were taken to Crystal Island. That was definitely the best part of the tour. If you wanted to go around the island, you had to pay a fee. In our case, we decided to go for a refreshing swim with the local people. At the end of the day, holidays, it's also about relaxing, not just about wearing out yourself.
Where are you?
Right here on Crystal Island. You know what? This is the best place ever. Absolutely beautiful. Look at the water. It's like if you were like in the south of Taiwan. I love it. One of the most beautiful things in Boracay are its sunsets. When you see them, it's like if you were in connection with the universe.
So, we're on a motorcycle, like tricycle, going to the seafood market to meet two friends that we made yesterday, someone from Thailand and someone from England. And we're really looking forward to listening to some music and having a few drinks.
To be honest with you, I didn't think that we were going to meet these lovely people. Nigel and Alung are absolutely amazing people. We had the best time ever with them. They are lively, kind, gentle, and extremely friendly. I'm very grateful to God that we met them here. If you want to experience the nightlife of Boracay, you definitely need to go to the Sea Market, where you're going to see many performances with real professionals. I really enjoy my time here. And after the Sea Market, we really wanted to go somewhere dancing. Therefore, we went to one of the many nightclubs in Boracay. By the way, most of the people were from Korea and Taiwan. I was kind of surprised.
Do you know, I've got to say that I'm so lucky that we met these wonderful people here in Boracay. And we've been having the best time ever. Unfortunately, we are leaving tomorrow and I just would like to stay here for another week. They are extremely lucky because they're staying here for another week. And imagine. Horrible.
Seriously. Partying in Boracay can become addictive. Therefore, we came to the same nightclub for a second round.
Hello everyone, so right now we are at Manila's International Airport. Unfortunately, we have gone to the end of this vlog. I've got to say that we enjoyed our time in this marvelous, wonderful country. And now yesterday when Richie and I got from Boracay to Manila, I actually felt like crying because we had such a wonderful time on that island that I just don't really want to go back home. But you know, what can we do? We are going via Riyadh, Saudi Arabia to Paris, and then Richard is going by train from Paris to Geneva, and myself, I'll go from Paris to Barcelona by train. So what do you think about the Philippines?
I think we thoroughly enjoyed ourselves here. Everything was a lot better than we thought. The weather was just perfect. Okay, we're now in February, so February is a very good time to come, especially to Boracay, because it's the beginning of the dry season, and everyone there is so friendly, and the beach is just like a few meters from like all the shops and restaurants.
And it is very safe. I've got to say that if you went to some Caribbean countries, you wouldn't be able to leave your hotel because you might be like hawked or like robbed. But in Boracay, actually, I've got to say that I felt as if it was like quite safe. So there is not that sense of like danger whatsoever. That's
not
my opinion,
all.
Of
not
course. In any case, we've got to say goodbye for now. And
so if you enjoyed the video, you know what you've got to do. You have to give us a thumbs up, please, and write any comments you have, and really important as well, please subscribe to our channel so that we can grow. We really want to grow, and we're really happy that you are watching our videos, and we hope to show you more interesting places very soon.
See you next time in a new video.